Hi, welcome all. Today we are going to discuss a topic called data types that are used in Python programming. Okay, so first we should know what is meant by data type. So from the name itself, it indicates what type of data that we have stored inside the variable. Okay, variable is nothing but a memory location where we have stored some values. Okay, so what type of value that we have stored inside the variable, that is called as a data type. So it mentions the type of data that is stored inside the variable. So normally in C language, every variable should be declared before using into the program, right? So what if you want to use some of the variable in your program, you must be declared, otherwise the error will be shown, right? So in Python, there is no need of declaration. So declaration and initialization will comes along with the single line. Okay, so no need of any external explicit declaration. So let us see what are the data types available in Python programming. So there are different types of data types available in Python. First one is numbers, strings, list, tuple, dictionary. So these two are main data types that we are used. Let us see example. So numbers means it may contains integer, float, complex, whereas in C language we are using an integer separate data type, float as a separate data type, then to mention the complex numbers we are using separate data type, whereas here all together mentioned as numbers. Then next one is string. String is another data type. So string means in C language we are saying that is collection of characters known as string. So if you want to mention a single character in your program, then you have to use the data type called character, right? So here in Python, if you want to use the collection of character or if you want to use a single character, whatever the character that you are using, it is enough to mention the string as a data type. No need to mention a separate data type called character. Okay. So whether it is a characters or whether you are mentioning a string, both comes along with the string data types. So no special character data type is needed. Okay. So single character can be treated as a string. So third one is list, tuple, dictionary. So these are the another three data types that we are using used in our Python program. So let us see with example. So in C, int a then semicolon, every statement will be ended with a semicolon. This semicolon indicates the termination of the program, right? Whereas in Python there is no need to mention any semicolon. Okay, so int a, the variable of the value of variable a equal to 5. So this is called as a declaration part. This is called as an initialization part. In Python, there is no need of declaration as I said before. So directly it is enough to mention a equal to 5. Automatically it includes declaration, initialization, no specific declaration needed, right? So for example, int a equal to 5. Two statements can be replaced by one statement in Python programming. So here in Python, we are just skipping the declaration part. Okay. So I'll show along with another example. If you want to add two numbers, what we are doing in C programming, we have to first declare the variable along with the data type, then we have to declare we have to assign the value to the particular variable, then we have to perform some operations using that value of a particular variable, right? So here I have taken int a comma b comma c, a equal to 5, b equal to c 6. If you want to perform some addition operations between these two variables, then you have to use c equal to a plus b. In Python, you just see how I have written the same code in Python. A equal to 5, B equal to 6, C equal to A plus B. That is, here I have skipped, here I have didn't mention any declaration part like int A, B, C, because A, B, C, these are the variables we are used in our programming, right? But we no need to mention these variables in prayer, right? Right. So I'll show another example. So here name equal to Python. Python means a name. This is a variable. This is a value. So here I have stored some characters as a character as a value to a particular variable name. So this is if you want to mention the character, then that should be included along with the quotes, right? So version equal to 3.6.5, price 300, C equal to 5 plus 4, 5. So name, the data type of name is string, the data type of version is float, then price is int, then complex number. So the same statement will be used in Python, that is not Python. This is the same simple this is a statement that we are used in C programming, but in the same statement we will be used in Python without mentioning these data types. Directly we can mention name equal to Python, version equal to 3.6.5, price equal to 300, C equal to 5 plus 4i. Okay, so and another one is if you want to mention any comment lines in C programming, then we have to use star. Whereas in here Python we are use hash symbol to mention the comment line. So the statement which is present inside the comment line will not be executed. So those datas will be included with the help of hash symbol in Python programming. So in Python, multiple assignments also possible. For example, in C we are using like this sum equal to 0, flag equal to 0, a equal to 0, b equal to 0, right? If you want to assign the value to a particular variable, then you have to assign like this. Then every statement should be ended with a semicolon. Whereas the same statement will be assigned in Python using multiple assignment. Sum equal to flag equal to a equal to b equal to 0. It is enough to mention like this. So the four lines of statement will be converted into the single line using multiple assignment. That is possible only with the help of Python programming. Okay. So here also I have taken another example. If the value of sum equal to 0, value of flag equal to 1, the name is Python, version equal to 3.5. If we want to use this statement in our programming with a single line, then that is possible with the help of line. You can mention sum comma flag comma name comma version equal to 0 comma 1 comma Python comma 2.5. That is the value of 0 will be assigned to the sum, the value of 1 will be assigned to flag, the value of Python will be assigned to name, the value of 3.5 will be assigned to the version. So you can mention like this. So single statement for multiple different values. So next one is another data type is Python tuples. So tuple is it's an immutable sequence of data type. It can contain mixed data types. That is, if you want to mention the different data types under one variable, then you can use go for Python tuples. Okay, here I have taken example. This is ordered and unchangeable. Okay, for example, fruit is a variable. There I can store managers, apples, bananas. So these are the different mixed data types that you can use. Okay, so next one is Python list. It is a mutable sequence of data type. It can contain mixed data type, right? So it is ordered and changeable. Whereas in if you use the Python tuples as your data type, then it doesn't. You can't change any order. You can't make any changes on it. It displays as it is, which you are given into the statement. Whereas here you can able to mention, you can able to change the order. Okay, the list apple, banana, cherry. Print this list apple, banana, cherry. Suppose if you want to mention the second statement alone, if you want to print the second value of a particular this list data means, then directly mention this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. The subscriptions will be okay. This list of 1 equal to banana. This is the if I want to display the result as cherry, then you have to mention the 2. So third one is Python dictionary. So it is an ordered collection of items. It has a key value pair. So with the help of key, we can able to access the particular elements which is present inside the dictionary. So dictionary is another data type. We have to create a dictionary using these curly operators. So my dictionary name Jack age 26. The name of the particular variable is Jack. The age of the particular variable 26. So print my dict of name. It shows the result Jack, then shows the result at 26. So with the help of key value, we are finding the particular variable. Okay, we are displaying the value of the particular variable. That's it. Thank you so much.